So let us start our today's session, guys. And the first thing that we have today is DBCA silent mode database creation. Because see, yesterday we created the DBCA database and then we also deleted it. So why not we create the database using DBCA by running it in silent mode? And how do we do it? Let us look at the activity. So this is a good chance for you guys to see how I'm going to create the database in silent mode using DBCA. So I'll go to our support website where we have all our Oracle articles. And then we definitely have DBCA silent mode. This article, DBCA silent mode. We'll be following this article in order to create the database by running it in silent mode. Choose 12C, we are working on 12C. All right, and let me open Notepad. Okay, so what I would do is I would copy this command. Okay, this is just one command, okay? And I'll start editing this command. So this is invoking the DBCA utility. This is the mode in which we want to run. We want to run it in silent mode. And we want to create the database. The template name would be the general purpose .dbc and global database name. Let's go with the test DB. You can change it in case if you want to. And then SID, I'm still keeping the test DB. Create as container database, no. And then enterprise manager configuration, none. Data file destination, U01 data Oracle test DB. And under the test DB folder, we are creating another folder called as DB files, and that's the location where our database files will reside. The storage type is file system. Character set, we are going with the default one. Total memory, we are allocating 2 GB to the instance. And don't worry, you can always allocate 2 GB because I think all the servers have 4 GB of the memory. But make sure if you are allocating 2 GB to one database, and if you're trying to create another database and you're again allocating 2 GB, it will be a problem because your total server size is of 4 GB. Okay, so if you want to create multiple databases for your practice and run, make sure only one database is running at a time. And then we have recovery area destination, and we are going with this U01 app Oracle fast recovery area. All right. And let me run this command quickly. So I'm already connected with Oracle user. And as I always say, a couple of commands you must always run: ps-ef, grep-pmon. Whenever you connect to any server, try to run this command and see if any instance is running. No instance is running. The next command is env grep aura. This will give me the environmental variables, whatever they are set. Of course, I am creating a database with the SID test DB, but the Oracle SID is set to prod. So later on, when I try to connect to the database, it will give me an error. So either you can change it now, or even once you create the database, then also you can change it. So what I would do is I would simply run this command and then see if it starts creating the database for us. So now the DBCA will create the database for us after okay, it's asking for sys user password. Let me enter the sys user password. I'm entering the system user password, and you hit enter and it will start creating the database. All right. So once the DBCA completes the database creation, then you need to change this Oracle SID. Either you can permanently change into the bash profile, or you can what you can do is temporarily you can export the Oracle SID variable and connect to the database. So we'll wait for this one to complete. Now, most of you people who never ran DBCA in silent mode, can you see how easy it is? Like just one command and it will create database for you, rather than having a GUI, clicking next, 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 and selecting the options. So real time, like as I mentioned, I haven't ran a GUI interface for maybe like past 5 years. So you don't install Oracle in GUI interface. You don't create database in GUI interface. You just use the silent methods because they're fast and easy to run. And most of the times, like for some clients, you schedule these kind of activities in the cron tab, Linux cron tab, and then it's easy, like it will create database for you automatically. So once this database is created, the next one or the next topic we'll be looking at is what are the different database operating modes, like how do you start the database, how do you stop the database, and then what are the key file locations that you should know. So meanwhile, let me pull up the architecture. Can you see we talked about parameter file, we talked about data files, we talked about control files, redo log files, archive log files, but where exactly these files reside? As I mentioned, there are a couple of things you must have it on your fingertips. These are, or finding these file locations must also be on your fingertips when it comes to becoming a DBA. And it's very simple, guys, like a couple of commands and you will get to know. All right, so we can see that the database has been created. So you can also check this log file, and most of the times this log file contains the same thing what you were seeing on the screen, but still let me cat it. Okay, we have other details, database creation complete. For details, check the log file. And I think this is the same log file name that we are checking, right? And database information, global database name is testdb, system identifier SID is also testdb. Perfect. Let us do ps-ef grep pmon, and we can see that testdb is running. At this stage, if I want to connect to this database, if I just type sql plus slash ssdba, and you can see it is connected to idle instance. That means I'm connected, I'm technically not connected to any database, right? Because either it is down or the database is down, the SQL plus utility has been connected. But we know that if the testdb is already up and running, then it should not say this idle instance. That means there is a problem with your environmental variables. So I'll just exit, and if you just type env grep aura, you can see we have the wrong SID exported in the environment. In this case, guys, as I mentioned, like there are two ways. Either you can make it permanent in your bash profile, or you can export your Oracle SID temporarily, like export Oracle underscore SID equal to, and I'll just mention testdb. So once you do this, what happens for temporary, like for the session that you're connected as the Oracle user, it will be changed to testdb. But if I exit the PuTTY, or if I disconnect from this session and connect back again, it will revert back to proddb, because in your bash profile, the Oracle SID is set to prod, right? So in case if you have an environment where you have multiple databases, it is better you set the bash profile to the database that you connect more frequently. It happens on servers, you have multiple databases. On the same server, you might have four or five databases. In that case, what you do is set your bash profile to the database which you access more frequently. And when you want to connect to any other database, you can export the Oracle SID like this, what I've done, and then connect to the particular database. Now let me connect to the database SQL plus slash ssdba. Now, do you see this? We do not see connected to an idle instance. This error is not there. And once you connect to the database, what is the command that you should run? Select name comma open underscore mode from v dollar database. For all the freshers, these are the commands that you must have on your fingertips.